Welcome to a brand new series of shows all about the LV County Championships. With the season just about upon us, over the next 6 months you're going to see plenty more of this. To kick off the first show, I'll be here at Lancashire County Cricket Club, the winners of the LV County Championship Division 1. In fact, the first time they've won it for 77 years. And this is the baby, the LV Trophy, with Lancashire newly printed onto it. So in the first show, I'll be catching up with Glen Chapple, the current captain, 38 years old by the way, Glen Chapple, and the head coach, Peter Moores. We'll be also having a look at Division 2 of the LV County Championship, and we'll be heading down to my old stomping ground, Chelmsford, the home of Essex County Cricket Club, where I managed to spend 3 successful years there towards the end of my career. Joining me here now at Bowden Cricket Club in Lancashire is head coach Peter Moores after a successful season last year for Lancashire, winning the LV County Championship Division 1. How are you doing, Peter?
Goughie, I'm good. How's you?
I bet you can still remember that sunny day, can't you?
Great game, actually, great season, but culminating because there was only 20 minutes of the season to go. I mean, we play 6 months of the year, and it goes down, I think, the Warwickshire-Hampshire game, they gave it up as a draw with about 20 minutes to go. We won with about 15 minutes to go. For the season to go to that point, and for us to be pretty well not sure if we were going to win it till probably the last 35, 40 minutes, it just made it a bit more special.
How do you move on from last year? Obviously, because everybody's been celebrating, I can imagine, all winter. And I know you guys have been back in working out probably from November on the fitness. So how do you make Lancashire move on from being the LV County Championship winners, Division 1? How do you move on for this season now?
Well, I think you try and get better every day. I mean, our winter program's geared about being physically fit, yes, but also getting more skillful at what you do. So we spend a lot of time trying to identify with players what it is they need to get better, be it bowling, batting, fielding, then go and try and get better at it, and then come to the season and try and deliver that. And it's worked for us over the last couple of years, hopefully again this year. Part of the thing we've got this year is that anybody who's won something knows the danger of being complacent is always there. I don't think it'll happen to this group of players because the majority are young, they've lots to prove, and we won so much as a collective last year that nobody... Lots of people had very good seasons, but it wasn't about one person. You know, if you wrote the team down against everybody's name, you could put one match-winning performance, and that's what made it a real team effort.
Just a quick one on preparation for this year. Successful last year, brilliant. The first decision you have to make as coach is overseas player. I think you've gone for Ashwell Prince.
We have, yeah.
Very reliable player. What do you look for in an overseas player? Rather than the obvious runs and wickets, what do you actually look for in an individual?
Well, I mean, I'll tell you what Ashwell does and what we like. Ashwell's committed, so he bought into the whole thing. So he's a tough competitor, and I think county cricket's about being tough. You know, you play a lot of cricket. So one of the things you've got to be able to do is be up for it every day. If you are, then you've got a chance. Ash came to us twice now, and he gets stuck in. He loves it. He works with other players. And when it starts as a batter, when it does a little bit, he kicks in. And we found the times he played at his best... Well, really, if we were trying to win a game or trying to save a game, which are the two most important times for a batter, that's when he really showed what he was worth.
Mm. And you made any more signings?
Well, we signed Nakishta here from Warwickshire.
Good bowler.
Yeah, good bowler. Swing bowler. Had one of those careers which I think a lot of players have had, where he's had sort of injuries all the way through. He's now 28. Often a bowler's body seems to settle around that age, so we're hoping it settles down for him. He managed to stay on the park. He can definitely bowl.
Well, if it makes you feel better, he's managed to get me out in his first-class career, so he must be a decent bowler. Anyway, thanks, Peter. Really good luck with your preparations. I know it's cold now and it's not looking great, but I'm sure the weather will improve and you'll get off to another successful start in the LV County Championship. Good luck, Pete.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you. Well, I've popped outside in the freezing cold here at Bowden Cricket Club. And here we have joined me, look who I found, Glen Chapple, Chappie, in his 21st season. That's one more than I did, mate.
Well, that's an achievement in itself, Goughie, yeah. No, I've done well with injury over the years, and I'm really lucky to still be playing. But you know, I'm enjoying it, and I can't wait to get stuck into another season.
Well, the amazing thing is, I remember when we first played against each other. Then you were obviously a young lad, slippery bowler, a good bouncer, ginger hair. I mean, now 21 years later, we played against you earlier, some great battles. You now got grey hair. But you're still in great shape, mate. I mean, how do you do it? I mean, has the game changed? Are you doing a lot more training these days?
I think we do more training. We do more specific training. But as I said before, you know, I think the problem bowlers have is knees, ankles, backs. And if you can avoid those, then there's no reason you can't go on. And I've been really lucky. I've only had one-off injuries, muscle tears, things like that. So. As I say, I've been lucky with injury, and I've enjoyed it. And you know, playing with a group of young lads who work so hard, it makes things easy.
Last season, terrific season for Lancashire. You got off to a terrific start. What were the highlights, though, for you of the season, besides that winning moment?
Absolute highlights: two games against Yorkshire, really tight finishes, unbelievable scenes, really, for four-day county cricket.
So saying that, the two close games against Yorkshire, so I can hold you responsible for sending Yorkshire down. I mean, how's it going to feel not playing a Roses match? It must be a while since you've not played a Roses match.
Yeah, they're great games to play in. They're the games where you, on a big stadiums like Old Trafford and Headingley, they're the games where you get a crowd in big enough to make it feel like a really important game. And obviously the rivalry between the fans, the competitive edge to the game with obviously the players, we'll miss it, there's no doubt about it. And you know, I think everyone here would hope that Yorkshire get back up into the top division as soon as possible.
Mm. And the LV County Championship, I do believe it's getting stronger and stronger with the two divisions. I mean, who's going to be the teams to watch out for this year? Because there's a couple of teams come up. Obviously Yorkshire have gone down, but Surrey have come up and they look pretty strong. They've got another young side, similar to yourselves. They've been in training hard whole winter. Are they one of the teams you're going to be watching out for?
Yeah, I think there's six or seven teams. I mean, I wouldn't count anybody out. Many teams wouldn't have had us down as favourites last season, definitely. So there's always a surprise package. You're right in what you say. Surrey are a very competitive young team. Made a couple of good signings over the winter. I think they've got Rudolph and Kartik from Somerset. Ramps is still churning them out. So
still.
Look forward to having another tussle there. But you know, Warwickshire are ever improving side. Durham are always strong. Notts probably underperformed last year. So you know, it's going to be a real tough campaign, and you've got to be ready for everyone.
Enjoy the year, mate.
Thanks.
And well done last year.
Cheers, Goughie.
Cheers, chap.
Thanks.
It's time now to concentrate on the LV County Championship Division 2. And I'm here at my old stomping ground, Essex, where I spent three very successful years, really enjoyed it. A lovely family ground, with all the lights on a permanent fixture. We did very well in one day cricket, but the LV County Championship is where you really want to really run it home and win the championship. And this is where I spent most of my time, the dressing room in here. These were just babies when I was here, by the way. These are some of the kids. And it's a small dressing room. It's not one of the biggest on the circuit. There's your captain, legend, Foster. And this is my spot. Unfortunately, the guy has just got out. How you doing? You're all right, mate. This is where I used to sit, this corner, out of the way. Spent most of my time watching the TV, out of the way in the corner. But obviously, when I wasn't bowling, I liked to spend my time either upstairs in a restaurant, troughing, so I got plenty of energy, or up the outside, up the stairs, on the physio bed, catching up on a couple hours kip. This used to be my second home. When I went in the dressing room in the corner, I was on here getting treatment from the best physios in the land, keeping me on the field. Obviously, we're having a dodgy knee in my later years. It was something I had to come in here every morning and be treated. So I used to tend to get here about 7:30, 8 o'clock, which is really early. But I had a flat just across the road, which was handy. And get most of my warm up was done in here. Well, that's my flat there, just there, right, just past where the netting. So I used to walk out the gate. There's a little gate there, straight through to the flat, straight through the gate, up the stairs, see the physio for a good half an hour, 40 minutes, into the change room. Nice hot bath, a bit of toast, ready to play. With me now, I've got my old mucker here, Paul Grayson. Started with him, what, how many years ago, Paul? 15 years old, Yorkshire?
Yeah, those days, yeah. I think we were Yorkshire schoolboys, wasn't it?
When he called me Pit Pony.
Didn't quite hit it off the start with, did we?
No.
But after a while, we were all became good mates and, well, very good mates, I'd have thought, so.
Well, it all started, like I said, we played together there at Yorkshire, played there many years. We ended up being each other's best man when we managed to get married. Yours yeah. lasted slightly longer than mine.
Yeah, yeah. You're back though now, so you're all right, aren't you? Yeah.
Well, LV County Championship, like I said, you're in Division 2 now.
Yeah.
You've played in Division 1 as well. Mm. I mean, what is the difference, Paul, between the two divisions? Because I think I've only played in Division 1. Oh, no, I played in Division 2 with Essex, didn't I? So, but what is the main difference you've seen over the last few years?
Well, the last couple of years I've really noticed is the standard pitches. The lack of heavy rollers has played a part, and also the tie flex ball. The tie flex ball's had a big impact on batsmen. There's been par scores have been a lot less in Division 2 than Division 1, and bowlers have tended to dominate that format of cricket. This year we've gone back to a duke ball, which I think makes sense that both divisions are using that. Four-day cricket is a real priority for this year. You know, we've been a good one-day side for the last few years, but the brief from the committee and the club is, let's give four-day cricket a real good go this year.
But it must be hard for you though when you're missing players. Let's say your youth system's brought two fantastic players through, Alistair Cook and Ravi Bapara, and it must be hard when you miss two players of that experience and that quality.
It is. I mean, we prepare for life without those two. You know, when we're picking sides at the start of the season, just if those two become available, obviously they just come back into the side and play. But we're very proud of the fact that they're playing for England, both established players now. Obviously, Ravi's got a bit more work to do to become a regular. I think we'll be lucky if we see maybe two or three games from this summer. You know, it's not frustrating, you know, that's life. I guess the only problem I have a little bit, and the club has, is the two lads that go to the IPL, Tendis Garter and Shah. You know, you sign those as county players, county journeymen, and then they get these great offers to go to the IPL. I mean, who are we to stop them going out there earning that sort of money? We know that county players don't earn big cash. So I think it's right for us to let them go out there. But the issue is that we lose Bapara, Cook, Tendis Garter and Shah, probably four
top order.
International players that are not available for the start of the season. On a positive, you look at it the other way, you give opportunities to Mickleborough, Westley, Godleman, Waiter, the young lads to come through. And it's up to them to make sure they play well. And if they do play well, they keep the shirt. So when these lads come back, the international lads, they will come back in and play. They've got to come back in the team. So two or three might have to drop out, but that's the nature of the beast, isn't it?
Well, hopefully I can interview you again in September and Essex go back up into Division 1 because that's the aim for the season. Good luck to Essex and good luck to you, Paige.
Thanks, Matt.
Cheers. So the LV County Championship is just around the corner. I mean, Division 1, who's your money on? Is it going to be Lancashire? Last year's champions, such a great effort with the amount of youngsters they had in their setup. Or will it be one of the newly promoted sides, Surrey and Middlesex? Another exciting brand of cricketer coming through the system. Young, athletic, fit. Or will it be Nottinghamshire, that experience of being up there year in, year out? And then we go to the LV Division 2, where they've got Essex, my old club. A fantastic club, plenty of batting, signed some bowlers in the close season. They've got Kent, another experienced county setup led by Rob Key. So they're the two counties in the second division I think are going to be really challenging to get back into that top division. But let's just remember, this is an exciting time for any cricketer. The start of the season, the pre-season friendlies, all the gym work's done, all the network's done. They're just finishing off the fine-tuning of their all-round game. And the first round of games is just round the corner on April the 5th. Good luck to all the cricketers in this year's LV County Championship. That's it for the first edition. Thanks to my guests, Peter Moores, Glen Chapple and Paul Grayson. I'll be back from April the 18th, but in the meantime, don't forget you can keep in touch with the LV County Championship every day throughout the summer by viewing our daily highlights packages here at ecb.co.uk/LVCC or on the ECB app. Bye for now.